Good evening all. My name is Alex Kelly and this is my spiel on nanotechnology, and namely its use in the creation of functioning blood substitutes. I hope to answer some of the major questions surrounding this field and suggest a few of my own for you to ponder. So first of all, what is nanotechnology? Nanotechnology is the creation of functioning devices at the molecular level, working at a scale of nanometers or 10 to the power of negative 9 meters. What is an artificial red blood cell? An artificial red blood cell, or respirocyte, is one form of blood substitute currently being researched in order to reduce reliance on blood donations, increase the number of situations in which a blood transfusion can take place, such as on a battlefield, and also to boost the performance and abilities of the human race. So how can we use nanotechnology to create artificial red blood cells? While currently only theoretical, a respirocyte is a robotic cell comprised of nano-sized components. It would contain an internal pressure of 1,000 atmospheres of compressed oxygen and carbon dioxide, contained safely within two separate high-pressure containers. They would power themselves on glucose already in the bloodstream, and manage carbonic activity through an onboard computer, utilizing chemical and pressure sensors. Also, due to their tiny proportions and expected advances in 3D nanoscale fabrication, the manufacture of respirocytes would be very cost-effective. So how do red blood cells work in comparison with their artificial counterparts, and what are the limiting factors associated with hemoglobin? Red blood cells function due to the special properties of hemoglobin, a molecule that is specifically designed to carry oxygen, taking it from where there is a high concentration, the lungs, and depositing it where there is a low concentration, the capillaries, while doing the opposite with the potentially toxic carbon dioxide. A respirocyte, however, functions without the need for this molecule. Instead, it would use specially designed rotors and filters to regulate the movement of oxygen, carbon dioxide, and glucose through the machine. While red blood cells are limited by the oxygen carrying capacity of hemoglobin, which is only 4 oxygen molecules, the artificial cells have no such problem, with a suggested potential to carry up to 236 times this. So how are we limited by today's current technology, and where do we go from here? Currently, scale is the only major limiting factor stopping us. While smaller and smaller robots are being created each year, there are still many years of progress needed to go before we're able to create functioning systems of this size, and many more involved in the design and testing of the rotor and filter structure to ensure absolute safety for humans. If there are going to be millions of these inside of us, they had better be safe. So why do we want to do this? What benefits would this bring to the human race? Well, first of all, there would no longer be a donor shortage. Hopefully, advancements in the production of blood substitutes will reduce the need for donating blood, as it can be a painful process and many regular donations are needed to keep up with demand, as you can see on the screen right now. I do, however, highly recommend that until we can inject you with a bunch of robots, that you come down to donate, because we are truly in need of donations and you are truly saving someone's life. Many countries have improper blood screening, often because they cannot afford it, and as such, an affordable and sterile blood source will protect many from infection. In Nigeria, the second most common source of HIV/AIDS infection is blood transfusion, and even in the most advanced hospitals, there is still no screening for mad cow disease, as it is a prion disease. People from the Jehovah's Witnesses sect will also be able to undergo surgery for the first time, despite their religion prohibiting the receiving of blood from another. The much higher oxygen carrying capacity of the artificial red blood cells will essentially give an extra 10 to 20 minutes to someone who experiences a heart attack, as their cells use up the oxygen stored in their designer blood. This will give them time to call an ambulance and wait patiently for the paramedics to arrive and restart their heart and take them to hospital for re-evaluating. Additionally, there will also be some other major game changers. For example, the capacity of super blood cells will allow someone as unfit as me to run at top speed for up to 15 minutes, or to sit underwater for 4 hours on just a single breath. Another group greatly affected will be divers. They will be able to dive for many hours on a single breath, while avoiding getting the bends or narcosis, both of which are caused by breathing compressed air underwater. While currently only science fiction, like so much in the field of nanotechnology, respirocytes are the future of the human circulatory system.